Hi everyone, in this video I'll show you how to create a pop-up for Wix in just 5 minutes. For this, go to popupsmart.com and get started. Enter your name, last name and email. Continue with next. You need to enter a password and your domain. Okay, let's accept the privacy policy and register. Okay, we are welcomed by the Playbook, where you can see all the ready-to-use pop-up templates. On the left-hand panel, you will see some goals. You can choose a pop-up template according to your business goal. If your goal is growing your email list, for example, we have the pop-up templates ready to use. If you want to increase sales conversions, we have pop-ups accordingly. Then we have some industry-based pop-ups. If you want to choose a pop-up template according to your business industry, we have seasonal pop-ups, different pop-up types like light pop-up, full screen pop-up, or floating bar pop-up. Also, you can use the filters right here to see animated pop-ups or multi-step ones only. Okay, let's see this one. It looks really good, so let's select it. Okay, now we are on the customize step. This is where you can add a new pop-up step if you want to. You can delete some of the steps, duplicate them, or rename your pop-up steps. You can also activate your teaser pop-up here. It's like a miniature version of your pop-up. When the visitors clicked on it, your pop-up will appear. You can also add new elements to your pop-ups, like you can add social share buttons, a video countdown timer, an animation, or some gamification elements. And we also have the form elements right here if you want to collect visitor information like email address, or if you want, you can just collect their phone number or their address, or you can just get some ratings as well. You can just do customization on the text of your elements. You can just drag and drop them if you want to change their position on the pop-up. You can also do necessary changes on your success step as well, because this is a multi-step pop-up. We have the email form field right here. When someone fills in this form, they will see the success pop-up. You can also see how your pop-up looks on mobile here. And if you want, you can deactivate or activate some of the mobile or desktop devices. Let's continue with style now. We have the theme engine right here. You can easily change the overall look of your pop-up with the theme engine. You can just see the preview, and if you like it, click apply theme. Or if you change your mind and if you decide that you didn't like it, click reset to go back to the original pop-up. Then you can arrange the size of your pop-up, and then you can just change its position on your website from the pop-up body style. You can change the background color of your pop-up. You can add an image as a background, or you can even add a latte animation as a background of your pop-up. Then we have the website overlay. This makes your pop-up more eye-catching. You can change its color as well. And you can change the shape of your pop-up. These are the shapes of the corner. You can also choose an opening animation. Then we have the text size font. You can change the color of the text on the pop-up from here. Then you can change the size of the text. Then scroll down, you will change the fonts here. If you want more fonts, you can click on more fonts, and you will see all the fonts right here. When you click on them, they're added to your font library, and when you scroll down, you will see them all. Let's go down to form style. We have the form element right here. If you want, you can change its color and its shape as well. And we have the button style. It's about the color and the look of the button element. And you can even change the look of your close button. And we have other options here as well about how you want the pop-up to be closed. And you can check out the success pop-up as well. If you need further and advanced customization, you can use custom CSS on the advanced style step, and you can just check the element adjustments here, but basic style is just more than enough. Let's continue with segment. When you click on change segment, you can see all the predefined segmentation options. You can choose one according to your needs, or if you want, you can click my segments to create your own rules from scratch. Some targeting options come by default, like visitor devices, newer returning visitors, but you can easily just click on them to activate or deactivate some. For this pop-up campaign, we are targeting desktop visitors, and we want to target new and returning visitors, and we want to show our pop-up on all the pages, but you can easily target specific pages by select this selecting this option and just pasting your subpage here. We also have other audience targeting options, like you can choose browser language or traffic source or operating system, geolocation targeting if you want to show your pop-up to a specific location only. And we have the user behavior targeting, like after X seconds, if you want to display your pop-up after a specific amount of time, or exit intent, if you want your pop-up campaign to be triggered when someone tries to leave your website. Then we have the frequency settings. You can display your pop-up on every page view, every session, or once every day or month. Or you can stop displaying the pop-up campaign when someone submits an email or clicks a button, or if they close the pop-up, or after a specific number of visits. Okay, once you're happy with your targeting, continue with publish. Don't forget to save your changes. On the publish tab, you will see your targeting summary. We have the autoresponder email. So since we have an email form field right here, maybe you want to send an email to people who fills in their email address. You can just edit the email right here. And then we have self email notification if you want to be notified when someone fills in your email form field. Or we have other integrations like different platforms you might be using. And lastly, we have the Google Analytics integration. Okay, once you're happy, click publish and you will see an alert window saying you need to verify your website. When we register for Popupsmart, we entered our domain, but we haven't verified our website yet. For this, I will follow the steps on the custom website section. So it tells me to copy and paste this embed code right here just before the closing of the body tag of my website template file. So I will just copy this and go to my Wix dashboard. On the left-hand panel, you will see settings. Scroll down to custom code and continue with add custom code. Let's paste our code right here. You can change its name and then scroll down. We need to choose body end from place code in and click apply. Okay, it's done. Let's go back to Popupsmart and we will click on verify website. It's visiting our website and Popupsmart installation is verified. It's coming back and refreshing by itself and our pop-up campaign is being published. Okay, let's see its online preview. So here is my website and here is my pop-up. Thanks to Popupsmart, we have created a pop-up campaign for Wix for free easily. So if you have further questions, feel free to contact us and I'll see you next time.